It acts as an archetype of what the genre can be at its best, as it analyzes the real world. Well, isn't that the point of literature? To send a message about humanity and our experiences here?
Well, I think I have to be very clear. Science fiction is a genre that speaks to some people, but not everybody. I know many people who can't stand science fiction, who don't like the genre at all and find it very difficult to relate to. And I even experienced that myself. There are some works of science fiction that I think are absolutely brilliant, but there are just as many, if not more, that I think are extremely flawed and just absolutely awful.
Well, but it's nebulous, and I guess the same could be said for science fiction. There's so many, it covers such a broad spectrum that it's hard to just narrow down and say, okay, this is this, this is that, this is that, this is that. You can say, what isn't science fiction?
Because it gives you a basis that people are taking an interest in the scientific aspect. If I walk in and I say, okay, there's a grizzly bear in the woods and it's killing people. Okay, there's the interest there. But if I sit down and say, well, this bear is rogue because, and I give you a lot of scientific facts to back it up, then it stabilizes the reality of it. It's not just some random bear killing people. This bear has issues, and so this isn't the norm. You know, Jaws they came out with, and they said, okay, this shark is swimming up and down the banks, killing anybody that gets into the water. Somebody jumps in the water, and the shark's miraculously there. Oh, and then we chase it down, we kill it. Okay, fine, nature gone wild. Well, then it labeled all great white sharks as predators of humans. And it labeled all sharks as bad, and people were afraid to go into the water because there's going to be a shark there and it's going to eat people. But then you say, well, here's the scientific reason why. Well, then it doesn't label everything, every bear, so to speak, as going to climb out the woods and chase after you and kill and eat you. It says this particular one does it because there's something scientifically wrong. And the science, people look to science. People think that science is the answer for everything. Think about when people go to see their doctors. They think the doctor has all of the answers because he's a scientist. And if he can run off the big words and say, this is what's wrong with you because, well, that solidifies it. This must be the case. Same thing with a science fiction movie. The science backing it up can solidify it. I was watching, actually, the other day, 2000.
Then you have straight what's become now known as horror science fiction, and that tends to be a little bit less sophisticated, but it still plays on genuine, you know, themes or fears that human beings have. They could be environmental fears. They could be, you know, a lot of different fears related to what contemporary issues people face at the time.
There are times you just don't want to have to think about stuff. You just want to lay back, and it's going to envelop you, and you're going to get hooked into it, and you're going to enjoy it, and you're not going to be troubled when you see it. You're going to be involved in it while it's there, and an hour later you'll want to see another movie.
You know, we study history. I mean, what's going on in our world right now is so very, very relevant to what we've studied in the past. And history does repeat itself. I mean, there's always a group who wants to be in power, that wants too much power, that has to put some other group down to get that power. And I see that, yeah, that's the same kind of thing in science fiction. That's why, I mean, yeah, it is out there. It does make us stretch our brains, our imaginations as far as possible. But at its heart, it's always a human story about, you know, learning from our mistakes and making sure that we are better than the mistakes that we've made in the past.
I think that good science fiction, just like any good fiction, any good genre fiction, any good literary fiction, is always in the eye of the beholder. What you may view and just inherently know as great science fiction, somebody else may be entirely and utterly bored with. They may think, I wish I could get my money back from the movie theater, or I wish I could get my time back from reading that novel. So
it's like in
the science fiction thing. It's, we know how long it took the guys to go to the moon. We know how long it would take a ship as we know now in the 21st century to get to Mars. And yet, when Han Solo clicks into hyperdrive in his starship, bam, he's at the other end of the universe in a split second. That it's not scientifically puff, who cares? I love seeing, you know, that's...
I believe a lot of science fiction does try to predict the future, and I think the track record is pretty awful at their success rate with that. Some authors have been more successful than others, but if you look at the whole of science fiction literature, I think the track record is pretty bad about predicting what the future will be. The reason many people love the genre is it provides an escape. It allows us to imagine something that's different, maybe something better, maybe something worse, but something different than the typical mundane lives that we tend to lead, that most of us tend to lead. And by saying that it makes the impossible improbable, I like that because it adds that random element I was speaking about before. You know, into the picture, you don't know what's going to happen in many science fiction works.
Let me see if I can put it this way, whether I'm talking to an alien or not. I think science fiction allows us to really think about what it means to be human.
Well, have we been able to pinpoint what science fiction is? Well, not really. No matter how hard we try, we cannot find a simple definition. But maybe that's part of why we love it. We get a look at our world from a totally unique vantage point, each more bizarre and incredible than the last. Maybe the fact that it is always changing is what draws us in, whether it be to face a pessimistic fact of life or to find a way to escape. So while we can't define it, we love it. And we will always desire for more. I am Greg Wyatt, and if you excuse me, I have some reading to do.
Tonight, I'm gonna have myself a real good time. I feel alive.
Buck Rogers, here's how much of a Buck Rogers fan I am. This is from about 1946, and this was the Buck Rogers U-235 atomic pistol used in the Buck Rogers movies and in the strip, and watch this. There's a cigarette lighter flint down in the window, and the sound is a zap that makes it flash like Buck's very own disintegrator gun.
What do you mean, Larry?
Is it like better to look over the camera than under the camera?
Okay.
That always had like a beautiful, scantily clad lady on the cover being menaced by what they called a BAM, a bug-eyed monster, and then the hero in the background coming through with both a ray gun and a sword.
They aren't needed. Aliens are popular. Aliens are common, obviously very popular.
I wonder if it'll be friends with me. Hello, ground!
The fact that life in Earth is often hell.
The most among the most amazing movies.
The only thing that went through the mind of the bowl of petunias as it fell was, oh no, no, not again.
It was brought out in the Get Smart series, called The Cone of Silence.
He had plans, he had wisdom, bullshit, man!
In three of those books that I mentioned, fire is definitely a symbol.
Interesting way to take a look.
Incredible.
Aliens are interesting. Intriguing. And obviously, it's a very incredible way to look at the unknown.
It is a human characteristic to love little animals, especially if they're attractive in some way.
Doctor, I am well aware of human characteristics. I am frequently inundated by them, but I have trained myself to put up with practically anything.
Spock, I don't know too much about these little tribbles yet, but there is one thing that I have discovered.
What is that, Doctor?
I like them.
Most honored bastions of sci-fi. 19... Oh my god, yes! Yes, oh my god!
That!
That's, no, that is true. Not that I would know.
That is going in the bloopers, congratulations!
I always liked Heinlein and his definitions and his view of life.
I'll go along with that. It's magnificent. I wish I had said it.
That is a fantastic description.
Yeah. Yeah, I understand that because, like I said, I...
gosh, that one's really, that's a tricky question in a lot of ways. And I'm sure Mr. Volker will appreciate this, this response here. I don't know, I disagree.
No, I don't totally agree with that. There is a definition for it.
I would not want to live in a world where neither science fiction nor porn were possible.
Okay.